Okay, I want to talk to you. Here's something. Here's a question that I was maybe a little afraid to ask you because I live in fear that someone will ask me. How do you reckon with nostalgia when you're writing and when you're arranging your music? I'll preface, mm-hmm. if you'll allow.
No, I think it'll help.
I've spent my last two records trying to remove all nostalgia from my music so that people wouldn't say it sounded like the Beatles,
mm-hmm.
or more specifically, Wings.
Mm-hmm.
And because I got tired of that pigeonhole, I felt it was alienating potential listeners, and I felt it was basically unfair, because that's not what I was developing my music to sound like. To varying degrees, it worked to try and get away from that. You seem to indulge in nostalgia. You seem to use it at every turn, both in terms of your gear, the production technique, and your melodies. So, are you afraid of nostalgia at all? Is maybe a better question.
I'm not. I mean, no. It's a complicated answer, because at the end of the day, it's taste. I enjoy the whole palette of rock pop history. I might get inspired from something off of Jerry Lee Lewis or Little Richard record. My girlfriend listens to a ton of bluegrass and hillbilly music. I'll be listening to a band like Prefab Sprout or the Smiths or Echo and the Bunnymen in my car. Switch the iPod and I'm listening to a Herbie Hancock record from 15 years prior. There's no difference to me with any of that. If something is infectious and passionate and evokes emotion, I'm right with it, and I want to figure out how to infuse my music with it. So, it does come down to preference. For example, we can say, Roger, you got a lot of old keyboards here in this room, some vintage keyboard sounds, or mellotrons and synthesizers and stuff. You put some of those classic tones on your album, yeah, and there's instantly going to be a nostalgic component. To me, again, if it assists the song and assists the mood of the song and the architecture of the song, then it needs to be there. In other words, I learned a lot of stuff working with Beck on this point. And you take a look at him, I mean, the guy is a nostalgia blender from hell. He's the epitome of reworking the past.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of the day, you're going, it still sounds like Beck. It's still all about him. And he has perfected doing that, in my opinion. I have always done that as well. Not to that degree. And those people who don't enjoy what I've done, past or present, will take that nostalgic element and use it as a nail to crucify me. I mean, it's a real obvious thing to latch on to. You know, when he's not busy doing his self-absorbed queen-like harmonies and his Steely Dan bridge interludes, well, depending on who you are and what you enjoy, that can be a negative, that can be a real slap in the face, or it can be a huge compliment.
Mm-hmm.
And it's you just have to be true and honest with if you're moving yourself to some degree, if you've sketched out a song or you're arranging a tune and you've come across something, nostalgic or not, that really completes the puzzle and really puts the frosting on the cake, so to speak, then you gotta you'll know if it's too referential. See, I constantly have that light on, that warning signal,
mm-hmm.
where I go, okay, I've crossed the line. Now it just becomes mimicry for the sake of get it, get the inside joke.